Introduction to Geotechnical Engineering. Now, before we go into the exact definition of geotechnical engineering, it would be easier if we know what are its various applications. So let's say we are at a site and we want to construct a building over there. So today I have visited this site. So do I start building tomorrow itself? No, right? Why? This is because we cannot do a guesswork of the ground and believe that the soil has the strength to carry the new superimposed load. So what we do is that we go for site investigation. So in site investigation, firstly you go to the site and then you do a visual study of this area. And to understand the properties of the underlying materials, you do field tests, and if required, you go for laboratory tests. So this is basically to understand whether the site is suitable for one particular construction purpose. So from site investigation, you get to know what is the type of soil, what is the strength of soil, where is the water table located, what are the potential problems that might arise, the suitability of the underlying material for construction purpose, and most importantly, you will know what should be the type of foundation that need to be designed. So we have n number of engineering structures. So here we have a small building, you have the Burj Khalifa, you have a number of buildings with various sizes and various shapes. We have the Taj Mahal, we have the Al Burj, we have a bridge, we have a tall cell phone tower, we have a dam, etc. So all these structures have different purposes. Or we can say that it has got different functions, and these structures will be imposing different loads, as well as these structures will be lying on different soils. So the foundation that you give for high-rising building will not be the same that you give for a dam, or neither the load that is coming from a dam will be the same as a load that is coming from a high cell phone tower. So you need to build the foundation according to the function of the building, as well as the load that is going to come from the building, as well as the type of the soil. So what is foundation? So foundation is basically you transfer the load that is coming from the building to the surrounding soil. Now if the foundation is located at a shallow depth, it will be called the shallow foundation, and if at a deeper depth, it will be called the deep foundation. So this foundation has to be designed as carefully as possible, or else you will be in irreversible situations. So now comes the geotechnical engineering. All the foundations of important, massive and cost-consuming engineering works will be designed by a geotechnical engineer. The properties of the underlying materials as well as the various subsurface conditions will be studied and analyzed by a geotechnical engineer. So basically you are studying what is lying beneath the surface. What is geotechnical engineering? It investigates the subsurface conditions, studies the underlying materials, deals with the potential engineering problems, and provides practical solutions. Now, there are various applications of geotechnical engineering. One of it will be design of retaining structure. So here you have a slope and you have made a cut on the slope so that you can build a road over there. All right. So this cut may or may not be able to stand by its own. So for the safety purpose, we design a retaining structure so that you will be able to hold the soil at two different levels. So as I told before, all engineering structures will be built on a foundation. So here you have a pavement or a road. So this road will be placed on a foundation, as well as you have got a slope over here. So this slope will be now having a new load that is coming from the new roadway, as well as the new loads that will be coming from the oncoming traffic. So you need to check whether this slope is stable or not. Also, you need geotechnical engineering for the safe construction of tunnels. Now, what will be the materials that you encounter when you're working on this site? So let's say that you need to build a massive structure at a site. So you will be drilling the soil. So you will be drilling the ground and collecting samples and testing. Or let's say that you are making a tunnel. So initially the top layer will be the organic soil or the topsoil. which is mainly concentrated on the vegetation part. And below that, you will be having the subsoil. This subsoil is mainly used for the construction purpose. Then you have the parent material, which will be the weathered rocks. And below that, you will be having the bedrock. So you can elaborately say that geotechnical engineering is the sum of soil mechanics, rock mechanics, and geology. Soil mechanics is the laws of mechanics that is applied. It is actually the laws of mechanics and hydraulics that is applied to soil. Whereas rock mechanics is the laws of mechanics that is applied to rock. While geology is basically the study that is related to the solid part of the earth. So in these videos, I'll be mainly concentrated on soil engineering. So what is soil? Soil is the unconsolidated material that you obtain from the disintegration of rocks. So you have these solid particles, and in between the solid particles, you'll be having voids. And these voids will be filled with air or water. The next video will be on the origin of soils, formation of soils, and transportation of soils. So till then, stay blessed. Thank you.